Royal Mail was hit with ransomware, Threema had some major flaws, and CircleCI was hacked. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for January 17th, 2023. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and jump right into the news this week. Now, Royal Mail, the main delivery service in the UK, suffered a major outage caused by a cyberattack last week. This occurred on the 10th, and it continued to cause issues and disruptions over the course of the week for folks trying to send mail internationally from the UK. Royal Mail described this as a severe service disruption to international mail exports, though domestic mail delivery within the UK appeared to be unaffected. Royal Mail hired a third party to investigate the issue, and they reported it to the local authorities as well, including the UK National Cybersecurity Center. The company eventually linked the issues to the Lockbit ransomware ops, as reported by The Telegraph. Now, ransom notes were printed on customs docket printers, threatening to release data to a Tor website if a ransom was not paid. Strangely, though, Bleeping Computer reached out to the Lockbit support public-facing rep, and they were told the attack did not stem from Lockbit, but was another actor using their leaked ransomware builder, which was called Lockbit 3.0, which was leaked on Twitter way back in September, but the ransom notes all link to Lockbit's Tor site for the negotiations, and 2 days later, Lockbit did take credit for the attack via a post on a hacker forum. According to security researchers, several serious vulnerabilities found in the code for Threema undermined its security and privacy assurances. Threema is a Signal and WhatsApp competitor based in Switzerland that claims to have strong security and privacy. The messaging app has over 10 million users, including government officials, and it's also a top downloaded app for many countries, including Switzerland, Germany, Austria, Canada, and Australia as well. Now, while it's another messaging app that enables end-to-end encryption, it also boasts having a custom-designed encryption protocol. Researchers at the ETH Research University found seven vulnerabilities in Threema. Two of them do not require special access, but they could allow an attacker to impersonate a user. Now, these first two flaws work as such. Threema allows ephemeral keys to authenticate users. So if that key becomes exposed in some way, an attacker could use it to impersonate the user. The second one is a flaw in the client-to-server protocol and how it interacts with the encryption protocol for end-to-end encryption. This could create a problem where the user inadvertently sends the attacker a set of characters that could trigger the issue, allowing the attacker to impersonate them. Three issues do require an attacker to gain access to a Threema server. The first of these three is due to a lack of integrity protections for metadata from messages, which could allow the attacker to reorder or delete the messages. The second problem is caused by a replay and reflection attack, so an attacker could resend older messages or duplicate messages and send them to other users. The last of the server access issues is a challenge and response protocol flaw, where the user authenticates with the server. Now, this one was patched in December of 2021 when it was first reported in a separate finding by a separate researcher. The last two could be used by an attacker if they had access to an unlocked phone. Threema lets users export private keys to port to new devices, but an attacker could also clone that key and the account unless a PIN or a password is set up on their Threema account. Secondly, a bug in the way Threema allows for backups and compresses messages before encryption could allow an attacker to inject strings into the backup and eventually do some recon and recover the private key. The researchers who found these flaws state that a custom protocol is the main contributing factor. Threema responded to the findings, saying that the issues had no considerable real-world impact and that the extensive and unrealistic prerequisites would have greater consequences than the respective findings, also calling them theoretical. But even so, Threema did mention a new protocol called IBEX or IBEX was planned and happened to be introduced at the same time as these findings. There is also no evidence that these issues were used in the wild, and they are all patched by Threema after the reports were privately disclosed. Apologies if you can hear my cat, she is chasing bugs. Biggest of shoutouts to my Patreon supporters, especially my golden s'mores and their fur babies, for making this show possible since we don't have ads on the show at all. And a huge thank you to John Chibs X, Peter, Martin, and Eric for being a part of the s'mores at patreon.com/Shannon Morse. Now this year, I will be migrating all of my perks and early access content to my Morse code Patreon and combining the two accounts to make releases and perks for y'all a lot more efficient. You can get ahead of this change by moving your pledge over to patreon.com/Shannon Morse. You will still get all the perks associated with this Patreon with the added benefits of my Morse code perks for the exact same, sometimes less, membership prices. So for annual ThreatWire pledges, I would recommend keeping your annual pledge active until closer to your resubscription date and then switching over. I will continue to keep posting things on both of the Patreon pages until enough people merge over to the main page, at which time I will go ahead and close down the ThreatWire one. Now let me know if you have any questions down below. My YouTube channel is youtube.com/Shannon Morse for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials. I also just posted a big wrap up from CES of all this tech that you will actually be able to buy this year, not just a bunch of prototypes that we will never see on the market, because that's what CES usually feels like. Do not forget to like and subscribe to Hacked 5 as well. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story, all about CircleCI. CircleCI is a popular DevOps platform that was hacked on December 16th in an attack that used malware to steal a two-factor authentication token and session from a legitimate employee's laptop. Now, this session hijacking or cookie hijacking allowed for the attacker to steal the login session from the employee's laptop and authenticate on their own hardware without having to re-authenticate with two-factor authentication. The malware used in this attack was undetected by their systems, so it was able to steal session cookies. The attackers used this session to impersonate that employee and gain access to production systems as a user with escalated privileges. The data they gained access to was stolen as well a few days after initial access, including customer environment variables, tokens, and keys. Now, this data was encrypted, but according to Ron Zuber, CircleCI's CTO, the encryption keys were also stolen from a running process, so it's entirely possible that they could potentially access the encrypted data. CircleCI started notifying customers to rotate all their secrets starting on January 4th, after one customer noticed suspicious GitHub OAuth activity on December 29th. That alerted the customer and CircleCI that their OAuth token was compromised, which caused them to rotate GitHub OAuth tokens, later rotating Bitbucket tokens, revoking project API tokens and personal API tokens, and notifying other customers as well. CircleCI responded quickly to this attack and has also limited production environments, and they are adding more authentication measures to prevent malicious attacks. Periodic OAuth token rotation will also be added in the near future. Because of this rise in bypassing MFA or multi-factor authentication with session hijacking attacks, Microsoft and Duo are both recommending companies and network admins add a new feature, which is called MFA number matching, to detect when a session cookie is being used in a new location. I suspect that we're going to see more of these kinds of attacks this year, but what do you think? Leave your comments down below. I'm curious to hear what the audience as well thinks about these new kind of attacks. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.